You don't understand.
Suffer not a witch.
Somebody shall kill.
Kill.
I know a lot of you. I don't know how some of you read your Bible. I know we have some ministers of God. Praise God for ministers. Some of them are in the crowd. So many people don't understand that the height of mercy is judgment. Psalm 136 says, he led them through the wilderness, for his mercies endureth forever. Pillar of cloud by day, pillar of fire by night, for his mercies endureth forever. He killed their firstborn, for his mercies endureth forever. So when God was killing their firstborn, it was mercy. I don't know if you believe. Do you believe the Bible? Kill.
There is a time for everything, Ecclesiastes 3:1, and a time to kill.
John the Baptist refused to kill, so a little girl ordered for his head on a charger. Wanted to use the head to charge phone. Charger. Ordered for his head on a charger to charge a phone. Because he refused to kill, I made up my mind that I will not be a specimen in the hand of the devil. I made up my mind that on my way to destiny, blood must flow. All the Hittites, those that eat their tithe, all the Jebusites, all the Amalekites, and all the ites and the tithes, standing on my way to destiny, they are going down. Some of you say, Apostle, but the Bible says pray for your enemy. That's true, but God did not give you prayer point. God just said pray, so you now know what to pray. Pray for your enemy. That's what we want to do now. We want to pray. So you fill in the blank spaces. Tell somebody, fill in the blank spaces. You know, I shared it with us. Somebody said to me, but Jesus said, forgive them for they know not what they do. I said, it's very correct. Only Jesus is permitted to pray that prayer. Because while they were killing him, they didn't know they were helping him to fulfill his assignment. He came to die for the world. That's why he said, forgive them, for they don't know they are helping me to fulfill why I came. I cannot pray that prayer because I didn't come to die. You touch me by mistake, I reply you by correction. They may have stopped your mother or stopped your father, but your case is different. Bishop, in class, you cannot fail a test and fail correction. You didn't hear me? You cannot fail a test and fail correction. So I'm the correction of the error in my family. I'm the correction of the error of my father. I'm the correction of the error of my mother. What stop them can stop me. What hinder them can hinder me. Let them pack up, I will pack up. I am correcting the mistake, the error of my parents. I am correcting the errors of my family. Lift up your right hand. Do you know there are some families? Wait, put your hand down first. Put your hand down. Do you know there are some families years ago they used to eat human beings like suya? Chop them. Beef. Roast beef. Chop them. Eat them up. One day, look at this. One day, somebody gave birth to a child. Myself and my wife were driving past. My wife says, a member gave birth. Let's say hi. As we were entering the house, I noticed a cat. Is it cat? They call it here. Puss. Okay. I noticed a puss was sitting down and was looking at us. So I look at my wife. I say, I don't like the way this puss is looking at me. She now said, please, let's enter the house. I said, no. The puss cannot even greet. So she said, how can a puss greet? I said, no. This puss is a witch. She said, let's go. The puss was looking at me, was keeping malice with me. Was keeping malice. So I look at the puss and I stretch my hand. I remember when Jesus cursed the fig tree. So I cursed it. I said, before I come back, you are dead. I released death upon it. And I left. We entered. We finished. We prayed. Well, I forgot what I said. So while we are coming out, I noticed my wife was using the leg to check. And the thing stretched. It was dead. So she said, you have killed somebody's puss. I say, it has no respect. If he come back to another life, he will learn to greet a man of God. Somebody say, it is time to kill.
It is time to kill.
Listen, I believe in redemption, in salvation. I spend millions upon millions of naira for crusades. We do crusades with thousands of people everywhere. So if I don't believe in souls, I will not do all that. But there are some souls that will not be saved until some souls die. Are you ready? Lift your hands. Tell your neighbor, don't disturb me now.
Say, my father, my father.
My father, my father.
Every power.
Every power.
Digging the grave for me.
Digging the grave for me.
Fall into your grave.
Fall into your grave.
Fall into your grave.
Fall into your grave.
Open your mouth and fire prayer. I got
Final prayer. Are you ready? One of the major advantages that Haman had over Mordecai was financial power. Somebody shout financial power. Financial power. Every man who wants to have a voice must first have a source. Without a source, you can't be a voice. Without a source, you can't be a force. God needs to bless you. And let me advise you. When one of the signs to get blessed by God, stop hating rich people. You see anybody that is rich, you are angry. It's a sign that you will be poor. Stop seeing it. There are people, when they see a new car, they are angry. Once they see a new car, they feel that the person, not everybody that is blessed is a thief. And guess what happened? He had the financial power. The Bible says, God is he that giveth you power to get wealth. Ability. What is power in science? Power is the ability to do work. So when he said God gives you power, it means God gives you ability to make money. Are you following me? Every poor man has compulsory humility. Every poor man is compulsorily humble because he has no voice. His poverty silences his voice. Let me shock you. Let me tell you something. A pastor in my country, a place called Lagos, a pastor, they beat the son of a king, a royal man, beat his sister. So when they beat, he's a prince. The prince beat up his sister, and the prince said, "There's nothing anybody can do." They told this pastor. So the pastor went to borrow 3 jeep. Not his own. No. He borrowed, he hired it. And he got, in my country, we call them MOPO, mobile police. If they handle you, your life will never remain the same again. Your eyes are red. So he got 4, 3 jeep borrowed, even borrowed the MOPO, borrowed the police, put them in their cars. He sat inside one of them. They beat his sister. He drove to that place. When he got to the palace, with the 3 jeeps, they moved around the palace. They did 360. Those who can drive know what 360 is. Went around. When he was coming down, all the policemen were opening the door for him, shooting the gun. He borrowed them. While he was still doing that, it was the king that came out of the palace to apologize to him. He said, "Sorry for my pikin beat your daughter. Sorry, sorry, sorry." Now, the king came out because of the way he came. If he went there with his leg to say, "Why did you beat my sister?" they will beat his mother on top. Bishop, Job said, "In that day when the secret of the Lord was upon me, I washed my feet with butter. The young men saw me and stood up. The old men saw me and their roof of their lip was cleaved to their mouth." For men to see you and rise, there must be something in your hand. In every family, the firstborn is the richest. The richest is always the firstborn. I'm telling you. Any family, the richest is always the first. How do I know? Even if he's the last child, if he's the one that is blessed, he's the one the whole family respects. Poverty, one thing about poverty, not that I hate poverty, but the implication of poverty is what I hate. love of money is the root of evil. The lack of money is the root of disrespect. Bishop, I know that there are times as a human being, there are times you may not have. But the disrespect that poverty brings. Poverty makes people that should not talk to you, talk to you. Poverty makes people abuse you, misuse you, refuse you, seduce you, and your life is scattered and battered and tattered and rattered and haggard and bushed. Because of poverty. I hate poverty. There is no part of poverty that is good. Say, let's examine poverty. Let's look for the good part. No part is good. You will pray. Are you ready? I say you will pray. Like you have, if you are sitting down, you are a terrorist. You will pray like you have never prayed before. Somebody shout, I must be rich. I preached a message years ago. That was the title. I must be rich. If you can pray this prayer with all your heart, money will enter your pocket. I don't like that amen at all. I say I don't like that amen at all. In your family, bishops are, money is important to preach the gospel. In your family, if people don't go to church, it's because your blessing has not been displayed. When God blesses you, your blessing is an evangelism. He preaches to people. Am I talking to somebody? Let me shock you. Jesus was not poor. The Bible says he had 12 disciples and one was a treasurer. A poor man does not need a treasurer. Judas was a treasurer. A poor man does not need a treasurer. Jesus was sleeping on a boat and the boat had a pillow. That was first class. That was not economy. That was business class. A boat that this he was sitting on the part that had a pillow. There were other parts, but the part that had a pillow, that's where Jesus sat down, first class. And there's something about first class. If you fly the plane, there's something about first class I like. If you are in economy, there is a curtain that separates the rich from the poor. But when you are in first class, you can go and greet your friend in economy and go back. But if you are in economy, you can never greet your friend in first class. That is the bad thing about poverty. If you are poor, you are limited. If you are rich, you have access. When there is a curtain and the hostess in the plane, they are very wicked. When they want to cover the curtain, they will look at all of you in the economy. Uh-oh. I wish you struggled hard. You would have been behind me. Manage where you are. Pew. They will first look round. It's very humiliating. They will look round. Uh-oh. Look at the economy people. And look at the name they gave it. Economy. It's close to the toilet. You have access to the toilet. Access. In economy, they don't ask you what you want. They give you anything. If you don't eat it, it's your business. The first time I flew business class, somebody bought it for me. It was not my, I didn't buy with my money. So I didn't know that you can eat anything. So a man by my side, they will ask him, what does he want? They give him menu. He order for toasted this, toasted chicken, lamb. They ask me, what do you want? I say, I'm fine. He pass. The man came back again. He said, what do you want? He took a pen. That man ordered. It was a journey we were to connect another flight. That was that journey. I ate nothing. The next flight we were connecting, this same man sat with me. When it was time to eat, they came to him again. And they asked him what he wanted. He took the menu, put on in glasses, and he began to tick what he wanted. They asked me. I said, I'm fine. The man asked me, are you okay? I said, the truth is that I don't have money to pay for this thing. The man said, what? This food covers, the money you pay covers this food and anything. I said, wait. You mean even that former plane? The man said, yes.
and said, come here. He said, what do you want, tea or coffee? I said, the two. Give me tea and coffee. I said, you mean I'm permitted to eat? He said, oh, I will both eat present, eat advance, and eat arrears. Listen, from my heart, I'm going to pray. And I want you to pray this prayer. All the people carrying my financial blessing, this 2014, you must locate me. Say, my father. As I begin to pray. All my financial helpers. In the north.
In the east.
In the west.
In the west.
In the south.
In the south.
Wherever you are.
Locate me by fire.
Locate me by fire.
In Jesus' name, lift your eyes to heaven.
I love you. I need you. Though my works may fall, I never let you go. My Savior, my closest friend, I will worship you until the very end. Jesus, lover of my soul. Jesus, I will never let you go. Taking me from the mire. Set my feet upon the rock. Now I know I love you. I need you. Though my words may fall, I never let you go. My
no.
Be tender.
You are holy.
For you love me. Righteous and holy. Oh,
Holy Spirit. Somebody say, I love you, Holy Spirit. Say it again. I love you, Holy Spirit. I love you, Holy Spirit. Say, I love you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Father. Say, Holy Ghost. You mean everything to me. You are my strength. You are my rock. You are my defense. I depend on you. I look up to you tonight. Glorify yourself in my life.